Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. So this is a feature release video, which is for nested carousel widget in Elementor Pro 3.14 beta. Yes, so they have released a nested carousel widget. So previously, when you were adding carousel widget, carousel slides in your Elementor, you were not able to design one single slide in the carousel. But now they have added this new cool feature in the beta version. It's not yet live. So in the beta version of Elementor 3.14, you'll be able to design one single slide in the carousel. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. My co-host Nida Sheikh will walk you through everything, how you can play around with the nested carousel widget in latest Elementor Pro 3.14. So without further ado, let's jump into the screen.
Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. First of all, I'll tell you guys how you can update to this new version. First of all, go to Elementor here and click Tools. Okay, here you can see Version Control. You need to click this, scroll down and enable Beta Tester here. Click Save Changes. Now, what we'll do is we'll check if we are updated to the new plugin. Click plugin and you can see that the version is 3.14 beta 2, and for Elementor Pro as well it's for 3.14 beta 2. So let's not waste time and add a new page and see this new nested carousel. Okay guys, so this is the screen where I'll be working on. What we need to search for the nested carousel is just carousel. Okay, so the nested carousel is in the name of carousel only. You need to drag it. As you guys can see, it appears in the form of slides. So from here, you can add as many slides you want or you can delete it. Nested carousel is we are not restricted to the same design or layout in each container. I'll show you how. For example, let's open Navigator first. Structure here, Navigator is open. For example, for the slide one, I want to drag an image widget here, and then I want some heading. Below this, like this, and a button as well. Some text and a button. Below this, some text and a button. Okay, so this is our first slide. Let's have a look. Okay, let me open Navigator here. And this is our slide one. You can add anything you want for every different slide. For slide 2, if I want like only the heading and text, so I can do that. Heading is inserted. Now, if I want text only, text, okay, let's insert it. Okay, we can do some styling here. Alignment middle, go to advanced. Okay, you can do styling for this as well. Okay, looks good. Okay guys, so this is what I have made with the help of nested carousel. Okay guys, so now I'll tell you how this carousel works, how you can do the settings. Okay, from here, let me choose structure. Structure is the updated version for Navigator. We'll choose carousel here. Now click content, and from here you can see slides on display, how many slides you want on display. If you want 3, you can select 3, either 2 can be selected. Okay, so it will appear like this, and 3 looks good here, so I'll go for 3. slides on scroll can also be changed if you want. So you can do that. Okay, if I go to setting autoplay, yes. Scroll speed, you can adjust it on your own. Whether it's good for me, direction either right or left, and transition duration can be chosen. Okay, arrows show. This is what the arrow means, so that you can click here. So I want it to be shown. Okay, if I go for pagination dots, these are the dots which it's talking about. If you want, you can choose something else or none. It is up to you. Let me show you guys properly. Let's click preview changes. Okay. Okay, so this is how it works. Previously in loop carousel, you were restricted to the same design or layouts in each container. But the beauty of this nested carousel is that we are not restricted to the same design or layouts in each container. As you guys can see, I've added different type of slides. I hope you like my tutorial. If you want more such videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button, and comment below.